I first got involved with Poetry Out Loud my sophomore year in high school. And it was pretty weird because I only heard about the competition 2 days before it actually happened, so I had a very limited amount of time before I actually had to perform. And I ended up getting second place, but the first place girl who was supposed to go to the regional competition, she ended up dropping out, so I got to go in her place. And from then on, I worked with the teacher who was sponsoring the program. And we worked on this for about a couple years, and I did it ever since then. And so ever since my sophomore year, I have done Poetry Out Loud, and it's basically been my life. I'm always looking at poetry, always reciting poetry. And I think that Poetry Out Loud has really been a very influential experience throughout my high school life. The first time I did it, I was a very awkward child. I'm still an awkward child, but I feel I have a little more experience now. I've become more comfortable on the stage. And I really learned how to connect with each of my poems and how to internalize them and find different ways to convey the message to the audience. And I think that's the most fun about this experience, is that I grow and I learn more about myself, and I get to find new poetry that I fall in love with, and I can read them every day, and I still have them memorized from years ago. And I really hope that I carry these poems on throughout my entire life. My first poem that I chose was Black Burying by Sylvia Plath. I chose that poem because I have a very unhealthy infatuation with Sylvia Plath. She is probably the most inspiring poet to me, and a lot of people find her very depressing. But I think her poetry is beautiful because she's part of that confessional era in the 1950s where it's very deep internal emotional experiences conveyed onto the page, which was often found somewhat taboo during the time. And the way that she takes these personal experiences and she manipulates them to relate to larger things such as social issues, as wars, and she's very infatuated with World War II, and she connects her emotional experiences to that, and I find that very inspiring that she can find these allusions to create throughout her internal experiences and convey that to her audience. And so that was my first choice, was Black Burying, because I love her, and the poem is very, there's a lot of meaning within the words, and it's, you've got to decipher it, and the way she wrote it was so beautiful, and I found it very inspiring. My second poem was Ecology by Jack Colum. I chose that because it's an absolutely beautiful poem. He wrote in such a stream of consciousness mode, and he's just kind of like taking in all of his surroundings and finding the world so beautiful. And I'm a nature person, and I really like the imagery that the poem provides, and I can really relate to that because I just love being out in nature. I like getting away from the city. And my last poem, Richard Cory, I chose that because the message, the theme of the poem, I feel is very prevalent, even though that is a pre-20th century poem. It's still relevant today because I believe the theme was that you don't know a person until you actually get to know them. You can't look at them and know everything that goes on internally. And I think that is something that people struggle with a lot today. We're so quick to judge, and we don't know them for who they are until we actually take the time to get to know them. And I think that is a very, very beautiful message. And so that's why I chose that poem. I wouldn't say that there's a particular theme in the poetry that I look for. I just read everything I can get my hands on. And when I read a poem initially and it strikes me, I know that that one is a keeper. I know that I can find something to connect with in that poem the first time I read it. And so I read it again, and I read it again, and I read it again, until I find that emotional connection and I can internalize it as much as I can to be able to convey that to the audience and perform it. And so I wouldn't say that there's a particular theme or poet that I look for. I just find what words strike me the most. If I could offer any advice to future contestants, future students who participate in Poetry Out Loud, it would be to just not worry so much about what the rubric says or what others critique you on. I would say just find that connection with your poem. find ways to internalize it and make it yours. And once you make it yours and you find that connection, it's a lot easier to just convey it to whoever you're performing for. And that's going to be the way you find the best result in performing your poems. Poetry is definitely not ending here for me. As much as I love reciting others' poetry, I love writing my own, and I actually hope to be a creative writing professor in the future and be able to carry on writing my own poetry. And what I hope to get from the experience at Poetry Out Loud is to find how these authors found their voice to spread amongst the world and find my own voice in poetry and be able to do the same as them and influence as many people as they did. Because poetry allows people to have a broader voice and to get their feelings and their emotions and their beliefs beyond just a single person or just themselves, and they get to tell that to the world. And it's a way you can immortalize yourself, and I find that very inspiring. And so I just hope to find my voice as these authors found theirs.